थैंक यू।
हेलो,
फिलिक्स,
हाय यामी, हाय
क्या?
यामी नाम।
हाँ हाय फिलिक्स, फिलिक्स
हाय, हाउ यू डूइंग?
हाँ
या आई जस्ट वांट अस आई वांट यू टू शो मी हाउ यू कैन आई मीन यू गेट ऑल दिस इनटू द एक्लिप्स फ्रॉम द प्रोजेक्ट फोल्डर।
सीरियस फिलिक्स, फिलिक्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गो टू फाइल। ओके
जस्ट अ मिनट प्लीज। Okay, so I go to file.
File, new.
Okay.
Project.
Okay.
Java project. Here you'll find like Java here, okay? You'll find like Java here, explore Java. There you'll find like Java project.
Okay.
Next. యా సుకదా ఇట్స్ ఆల్రెడీ రికార్డింగ్ సుకదా ఓకే గివ్ యువర్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ నేమ్ హియర్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద టాపిక్ ఐ టోల్డ్ దట్ టుడే విల్ బి డిస్కసింగ్ ద టాపిక్ విచ్ టాపిక్
I think is it command line or something?
Oh, command line arguments. So now I'm creating a project name as command line arguments. Command line args. Okay. Next.
So you have to name it exactly the way it is in the file, right?
It's a project name.
Okay.
Say next and finish. Okay. Clear till now, Felix?
Yeah, but
then
explore. Okay, yeah, it's clear up to now. Yes.
Then the source is now here. Right? I click on the source. New class.
Okay.
Okay. Simply give you let's say now we are going to work with command line arguments, right? I am giving like demo 1. Okay, I don't have main method, so I am saying here main. I am saying finish here, finish, so it will finish now, right? See, program is there now here. Maybe also have main method, everything is automatic. Instead of main method now, I'm writing here. This how control space, it gives you completely, okay? Now, command line, total number of arguments are plus args. Come on, Felix, what is args here? Args is array variable, right? Yes or no, Felix?
Right.
Args is single dimensional array variable, right?
Right. It's array variable.
So, it is string single dimensional array variable, right? Now, I want to find its length now. How can we find? I mean, it means it's array variable, right? Already we have learned work with arrays. There you have seen how to find out length of array variable. Do you remember? Felix, do you remember?
What's that?
Yeah, how to find out?
To find out the, do you say the length or something? What? I didn't get the question.
I want to find out length of this array variable. Here we have array variable, right? Earlier we have seen work with array variables, no? Integer array variable. Similarly, here it is a string single dimensional array variable. You are right, Shweta. Okay, it is string single dimensional array variable. I want to find out its length now. So how to find it now? Atiya, how to find out?
this string dot length.
Variable name dot length, okay. So here we are, our variable is named as args here. So args dot length dot length. Automatically it shows you, right? We are giving length here, okay. So okay. Now I want to display all those arguments now. How can we display? We can iterate a loop now. For int I is equal to 0, I less than args dot length, I plus plus means I equal to I plus 1. Right. Now we are displaying here like one argument here, okay. So args of index, right? So it displays you all the values here, okay. So you can display here before this sysout all arguments are send we have all arguments, okay, correctly run as Java application. But right now, how are we going to execute now? We are going to pass some input values, right? Yes or no? Now for this program we have to pass some command line arguments, right? How to pass now? Right click on the program, run as, run configurations, okay, run configurations. Now we need to say here arguments are there. Here is our project. Here, what is our project? Here it is so like dynamic density. It is not our project. No, what is our project here? Our project belongs to see arrays. It is not arrays, so we need to modify it as command line arguments. So choose our project name first of all properly. Then what's the main class here? Our main class is like demo one. Select it. Okay. Application is ready right now. Yes. What is this now? Arguments. Click on arguments now. I'm passing now here. I'm passing arguments like Abu Talib. Felix. Shraddha. Sushma VJ, okay. Again, all the values, okay. Now, what to do now? I'm saying now apply. So, I'm passing the whole values here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They're passing total 5 values now, okay. Apply, run. See how the output here? Total number of arguments are 5. All arguments are Abdulib, Felix, Shraddha, Sushma, Vijay. It is showing us all the values you have given there. And it also gives you count here of all the arguments you have passed. Understand? So according to our requirements here, we can pass any number of arguments. What are command line arguments? If at all we are passing any arguments to main method itself. Right? Earlier we said no, calling sum method, division, multiplication, so on. We have seen lots of methods, right? Earlier we are seeing calling lots of methods and we have passed arguments for those methods, right? But right now here we are not going to pass any kind of arguments to normal method. We are going to pass the arguments directly to our main method. Understand? Which is a standard method. So now see here, for our main method directly we are passing all the required arguments. How simply now here we are calling. While we are executing main method here, we are passing all the argument values to run as run configurations. And we are first of all main, we need to select our project name, then choose our main class name, go to arguments, provide all the argument values. So what are the argument values we are providing here? All these argument values will be directly given to main method. Once we input all the details here, we can say like run. Once you give all the input values here, directly we can say run button. Once you click on run button, automatically it executes you all the applications properly, no problem at all. Clear now? That's the way how it works. Right? So what are command line arguments? Passing arguments to main method. Passing arguments to main method. So the arguments which are given to main method are called as command line arguments. Okay. So in this way here we can capture argument values through our end user and we can store into our application according to our requirements. Okay. Now, so now here we are giving all these values, right? We are fetching all the values we have in our array variable. Okay. Now, I want to pass a value like this. Felix, what's your full name, Felix? Felix?
Yes.
What is your full name?
Dumoye. D-U-N. M-O-Y-E.
Is it right?
Yeah, that's right.
Huh? So here we are giving it as Dumoye Felix here. But it will be taken as two separate words. Why so? Because we are giving space here. So it shows you like two separate words. See now the output here. So if you don't want to make it as two separate words, see now I'm saying run now. So see the output here. Total number of arguments are 6. All arguments are Abudarib, Dunmoyi, Felix, Shadda, Sushma, Vijay. So it is taking Dunmoyi and Felix as two separate words. I don't want that to happen. I want to make them run as a single input value. How to do it now? In our arguments here, we will enclose the entire name in double quotes. So at all we enclose the entire value in double quotes. It may have multiple spaces, no problem. Whenever we enclose the values in double quotes, see, run it now. Excuse me. Now it is showing you number of arguments are as 5. See, Abudalib, so Dunmoye Felix. So right now it is showing you these both words into a single value. Why? Because we have enclosed the value in double quotes. So it is considering our value as a single value. Understand? Same way we have also given values of rest of names. Right? Is it clear out to you all? Right. So now we'll see. By default, see here, it is syntax here. So we cannot give any type of here, okay? We need to give only string type here. Understand? So we can't say that we can go for integer array or double array or any other array, what we like, okay? It's mandatory that we should go for only single dimensional string array variable. That is what syntax is again. We need to follow the same. Understand? We have no other option. We need to follow for the same. Understand? Right. And see now here, whatever the arguments you want to pass here. But you may pass data belongs to integers or numeric or whatever data you are passing there. We need to use entire data here by making use of string single dimensional array variable and we need to convert here. Okay. So if at all you have to do some calculations, we can convert them into integers or float or anything else. Okay. According to our requirements here, we can convert it into respective type of data and we get to required operations. Is it clear now? Here it's not like that. It's not Felix. Here we cannot pass values from spreadsheet here, okay? If at all you have to use read spreadsheet, again we can see that as a part of JDBC, okay? In advanced Java, we'll learn working with JDBC API, Java to database connectivity. There we will read values from spreadsheet. Okay, so into program we can read data of spreadsheet, no problem, but we need to have that API. Okay. will see them as a part of advanced Java. First of all, is it clear to you all, everybody? Any queries till now? Right. Now we go for next. Right. Now we will see next here, okay? We will see now how to pass different arguments and how to convert them into our own type, okay? See now here. I'm taking second application now. See here. New class and take it as conversions. Okay. Conversion. See, I want to have main method now. Finish. See now here. Now I want to take two numbers now. Okay. So see, int a is equal to, I want to take integer value now. So our before we do this, we need to accept string value, right? String s1. Str value is equal to args dot args of 0. Okay, I will first input value here. Okay, now I want to convert it into integer. Now, how to convert now? Integer dot parse int, and we're passing our string value as a argument. Okay, right. So what happens now? What are the string value we are having there? The same value will be converted to integer now here, and gives to value 1. I'll give it as number 1. Okay, same way now we should also go for number 2. What is integer and parse int here? Integer is a class, whereas parse int is a method. Come on, in which case we can call method name through class name directly? Atiya? Atiya, Abu Talib, yes. Not static class, Ishma. Static method, okay. Yeah, right, very good. So if at all the method is static method, then we can say now class name dot method name. Understand? It should be a static method. So directly we can say a class name dot static method. Understand? See now here, integer dot parse int of string value. See now here. So here we are accepting second number as well here. See, string value 2 is equal to args of 0. So here now second input value will be given now. Like we are giving like 1, args of 1. Args of 0 indicates first cell value. Args of 1 indicates second cell value. Now it will be copied into string variable 2. Now what are we doing here? We're converting it into integer. See, how are we doing it now? We are using predefined class integer. Let's see now, integer dot parse int. We're calling a method parse int, and we are passing our variable as a argument here. Okay. What happens now? Simply here, whatever the argument we are having here, the same thing we are passing it as a argument now, and displays you like integer value now. Okay, so you know here, this out. See, for usual, let's take some variable. Okay, yes, as a part of a Java program, wherever you want, you can declare a variable dynamically, no problem. Sum is equal to, I want to find out now, sum of number 1 plus number 2. Now we'll display here. Come on, sum is sum. So here, now how to execute this now? Come on. Shraddha, tell me steps now. How to execute this?
We have to run it as a configuration.
Okay, run as. Run the configurations, next.
Then pass the arguments using the argument tab.
Before that, make sure our priority is over here and our main class is over here. What is our class here? It's not demo. What's the class here?
Command line.
Convergence.
Convergence.
Search. It's convergence. Right. Up and go to arguments now. Come on. How many arguments you need to pass now?
Two arguments.
So both are integers now. Because
yes,
we are reading them in string format and we are trying to convert into integer format. Because by default, the data what we read in our program will be nothing but string data. You may give integers, you may give names, you may give anything here, okay? The data what we give here is by default in the form of a string, okay? So now we are reading it now and directly we are migrating. Let's see now here. Arguments 10, 20. So now we can internally in our program, we can convert them into integers. See now here. The input values we have, provide all the input values we require, run. Apply and say run. See now here, it is showing output as 30. So, what are the input values we are passing there? It is showing you addition of both the input values we are passing. Understand? Simply thing is here, we convert integer type into integer dot parsint. So, parsint is a static method of integer class. So, directly we can call it. So, it will convert the value into numeric type. So on, okay? In the same way, we have a lot of classes, okay, see, here integer and parsing, right? Similarly, we have parsing method in many classes, example, float class, float dot parse float, double dot parse double, so on, understand? We have lots of methods. As we are using integer class now here, same way, we can also use double class, double dot parse double, understand? Integer dot parse, see here, example, I'll show you here, so double dot, see, say dot here, parse. Is it showing you or not here? Parse is or no? See, I'm commenting it here. Only for demo. Okay. Say, same as here now. Float. Dot. Parse load. Float. Dot. Parse load. Okay. So on, we give you respective values, understand? So maybe any type, okay? So almost in every, in all these classes, we have a method called as parse method, okay? We call them as parse triplex method. Example, see, parse int, parse double, parse float, so on, understand? So anyway, however it is here, the data which we are reading here will be there only in which format? String format. String single dimensional array format. What to do now? We need to read all those values one by one and simply convert into a respective type we have. Right? Is it clear now to you all, everybody? Any queries here? Right? Go on, next. So simply now you do one thing, okay? I want to display, see, I want to accept name, number, okay, name, number, mark 1, mark 2 of a student, okay, and I want to display total marks of student. I want to display number, student name, and total marks of student, okay? All right. How will you do it now? The same program you can modify. Okay? We'll do this. Athiya, will you do this? Athiya? Athiya? Are you there, Athiya? Okay. Abdulib, will you do this? Abdulib? Shraddha, will you do this? Okay, so the I'm passing you keyboard and mouse and mouse control. Modify the same program. Okay. I want you to accept how many details? One is student number. Two, student number should be integer variable. Okay. Store student number in integer variable. Next, student name. Okay. Then mark one, mark two. Right? Then find the total marks and display number, name, mark one, mark two, total marks. I want you to display all these details, okay? Modify the same program, do all the required changes and show it quickly. Very quick. Meaningful names, okay, Atiya, Atiya, no, sorry, Shraddha, you meaningful names, okay? Yeah, for name, what you are given here? For name, you are given it as strvar2. Give it proper name over there. Yeah, second, yeah. What is that? We use it in a program. What is it? Random one mistake here.
Sorry, sir.
Sorry, sir. There's random one mistake here. Array index always has a 0, but aggregate index has 1.
I'm taking the 0th argument as the name.
Huh?
The first argument as the student name.
Name, is it? Then you should give here like 0, right? For name.
Okay.
Redirect to.
Okay. I'll take the first argument as the name of the student.
Yeah, yeah. Then in the case, first I'll give some variable name here.
Okay.
Oh, wherever it is, wherever you want, you can give here. Already you are declaring here, no? Yeah. Right.
setup.
One minute, maximize the program. Maximize the program. Shraddha?
No.
Maximize the program. Click on this. 1 minute. Let me take the control. If you click on this, program will be maximized, right? Yeah. What are you saying here now? Steer valve 2. Yes. Mark 1. Why are you showing error message here?
Sorry, sir.
Cannot be resolved. Steer valve 2.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear you again like valve? Did you hear you like where?
Okay.
Okay. Be careful, okay? One minute. Valve. 1 minute. Insert. Steer valve. Oh. Steer valve. Valve. Mm-hmm. Copy this. 1 minute. Okay. Same way here, you are copying number, okay. Convert into integer, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is your valve, where is this here? Student number, okay, fine. Name, okay. Number, okay. And, so valve 2, okay. Number 2, we are converting to integer number mark 1. Now again, arcs of 3, okay. Valve 3, okay. We convert it to mark 2. Total maximum mark 1 plus mark 2. Student name is name. In new line, again, you display the student number is. So, is it displayed there properly? Yes, yes. Then mark 1 and max 1. Okay, we are displaying now. Max 1.
Yeah.
Okay, however it is, you are able to do some, right? So, here some more, one more mistake is here. What is that? This is valve 3. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So, next your number 1. Okay, again, like mark 1 and mark 2, right? So, give same thing here also, okay?
Alright.
Mark 1. Here mark 2. Okay.
So that
variable names. Yeah.
That is the previous program statement. I have written it over here.
Once again. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then what? Simply display total then, okay? 1 minute. Let's comment this now. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Sum is here is total marks, right? Yes. So simply copy the total here.
Mm-hmm.
Here write total here. Okay. Save. Your semicolon is forgotten.
Mm-hmm.
Use semicolon. Save it now. Right click. Run as. Run configurations. Arguments. First thing is name, right?
Yes.
Name as Shraddha. Next, what are passing there? Number, right?
Yeah, student number.
1, marks rate, 99, 100, apply, run. So here, student name is Shraddha, number is 1, marks are 1, mark 1 is 199, it is showing production total here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's modify now, like total marks.
Okay.
Okay. We are doing it like this. Right. Any queries here? Is it clear to you all how to work with this command line arguments? Right, everybody? Okay, any queries here regarding these conversions, any of you? Yeah, if you have any questions, please ask me, or else you can raise your hand and ask me your questions. No queries? Right. So if no worries, we'll discuss about the next chapter, object-oriented programming.
Prasad?
Yes.
I think there's a class that rubber class that has to parse types as they are from one place, right? I mean, a class that reads and parses integers, doubles, all of them from one place. You know it?
I did not understand. Can you explain again, please?
Well, you use integer and double parse int.
Okay. Yes,
and
yes,
these
yes.
are static variables. There is another class that takes in a file, say a whole file, not just arguments, and parses.
Okay. So yeah, we will read. Obviously, in our code Java, as the last topic, we have IO streams. Okay. At that time, we will learn how to work with reading files. Okay.
Okay.
Nothing to worry now.
But can we use that concept in here?
Yeah, yes, we can pass file name as argument. Before reading file, we can take file name as a command line argument, okay?
Okay.
And whatever file name we have given there, we can read the entire file. Okay, we will say at that time, don't worry. Okay?